Hi everyone, and welcome to our Holy Week reflections. Today, tomorrow and Wednesday we'll follow the same pattern, and then on Thursday we'll have a Holy Communion service, and on Friday we'll look at the stations of the cross as we reflect on the crucifixion. And then of course on Sunday we'll have our celebration service. It's a week of mixed emotions as we try to understand what it might have been like for all those who were with Jesus as he walked towards the cross, and then beyond to new life. As our week begins, we're going to reflect and look at some pictures. We're going to listen to a Bible story before reflecting on how we might have reacted if we had been a part of that story. So as I said, we're going to look at pictures, and I will show you a picture with some music for about a minute, and you will be able to reflect on what that picture might be saying to you. And then we'll hear the Bible reading, and then we'll have just a couple of minutes silence at the end of that as we think about and reflect on what we've heard. And then we're going to sing, and we will end with a prayer. You might want to light a candle, as I have here behind me, and you might want to get yourselves comfortable so as you sit you can invite Jesus to come into your heart and help you in your reflections. So here is that first picture, and we'll take about a minute to reflect on it. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not what I want, but what you want." Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "So you could not stay awake with me 1 hour. Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again he went away from them for a second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand." So now, as we reflect on the picture and on that reading, who might you be in this story? Are you like Peter, always there for Jesus, always ready to step up and defend him, always wanting to please him? How do you feel about seeing Jesus in such pain, watching him as he cries out in agony. And then when he asks you to keep watch and stay awake, you fall asleep. How does that make you feel? Do you feel like you have failed him? Perhaps you feel like you might be James or John rather than Peter. How do you feel being asked to go with Jesus and Peter and not knowing exactly what's going to happen? How do you feel leaving the other disciples behind? Do you feel superior to them? Or do you feel that you are just being put upon? Maybe you feel like you're one of the other disciples left behind and not sure about what is happening. How does it make you feel to see the others being chosen when you have been left behind? Does it matter? Is being there for Jesus enough? Or do you need to feel special too? And now to our second picture, and again a minute's reflection with some music. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him." At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you are here to do." Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. Suddenly one of those with Jesus put his hand on his sword and drew it, and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to him, "Put your sword back in its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say it must happen in this way?" At that hour Jesus said to the crowds, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled. Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. So how might all the people be feeling in this story? What about Judas? How might he be feeling? What made him do it? He thought Jesus had come to fight the Romans and set the Jewish people free. When he realized that was not who Jesus was, how might he have felt? How might he have felt when he betrayed Jesus to the authorities? How might he be feeling now as he kisses his friend, knowing why he is doing it? What about the religious leaders? How do you think they felt as they watched Judas kiss Jesus? What about the man with the sword? What might he have felt as the soldiers grabbed Jesus? How might he have felt when he swung his sword and cut off the servant's ear? How might he have felt when Jesus reprimands him rather than thanking him? And what about the soldiers? How might they have felt? After all, they're just doing their job. Finally, what about the disciples? How might they have felt watching a friend betray a friend? And what made them run? So now we're going to sing as we continue to think about all those things, how those people may have felt. And we're going to sing Meekness and Majesty.
This is your God. unsearchable, God the invisible, love indestructible, and frailty unreal. Lord of infinity, stooping so tenderly, lifts our humanity to the heights of His throne. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty.
So as we come towards the end of tonight's reflection, let's pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility, and also be made partakers of his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.